Hey guys, so in this video what I'm going to do is I'm going to take the Ubuntu terminal and take it from this simple bash prompt and convert it into something like this. So it shows the icon of the distro that you're on, your directory. You can see there are these nice icons. It also shows that this particular repository is being hosted on GitHub. It shows the name of the branch. It shows that I have one commit that I need to push. So let's see how to get this. So the way to do that is, first of all, we're going to want to install zshell. Okay, so it's a simple command, sudo apt install zsh. Oops, that was too fast. And this is going to go ahead and install zsh for us. There are quite a few benefits for using zshell, and for example, you don't have to worry about the case sensitivity of the files or directory names. You can just copy and paste commands from the internet and they won't start executing immediately. So even if they have line breaks, they're not just going to run. It's going to select them and you can modify before doing anything. Okay, so once this is installed, what you're going to want to do is change the default shell to zsh. So by default, Ubuntu comes with bash. So you can see that by writing echo and then the dollar sign and zero, and you can see the running bash. And to change this to zshell, you have to write something like this, chsh, change shell. And then press enter. It's going to ask you for the password of the root. Press enter. And here just type /bin/csh. Now at this point, you have to log out from this, from your session, and log back in, or you can just simply reboot the machine. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna reboot this and see you guys when it is rebooted. Okay, so now we have rebooted. Let's open terminal again. And this time you'll notice that you're greeted with this prompt that you have to follow. So what it's asking you is if you want to customize these settings. What I generally do is I just populate with the configurations recommended by the system administrator. So I'm just going to press 2 and we're inside zshell. And you can verify that by writing the same command again. Okay, the next thing that we want to do is we would want to install oh-my-zsh, or oh-my-zsh, or whatever you want to call it. So we're just going to go to install oh-my-zsh, and this is also really easy to do. All you got to do is just scroll down and right. This is the button that I press, and then simply copy this and paste it into your terminal. Okay, so since this is a fresh Ubuntu, like I mentioned earlier, we need to install curl. So let's install curl. All right, so let's go ahead and try that again. Great, we also need git. Okay, should be good now. Great, so now you'll notice that the prompt has actually changed a little bit. And that's because now we are using this oh-my-zsh Now we need to install a theme for oh-my-zsh, and it is called powerlevel10k. And again, we just have to paste one command here. So I'm just going to copy this. Let's go back here and I'm going to paste it. Now at this point, you would want to do something which is not mentioned in these guides, right? And that is to get a proper font which contains all the icons for the new prompt that we're going to see. So to do that, I actually already have it set up in one of my repositories. So you can actually, I'm going to leave this link in the description, but it's actually github.com/ibn-yusrat/my-linux-setup. And here you're going to see this folder called powerline fonts. And all you got to do is you got to copy these and you have to install them. And the way I would do it is, let me see where I am. I'm in my home directory. So I'm just going to clone this. And once it is cloned, what I'm going to do is I'm going to take the fonts and I'm going to copy them, all of them, into the directory that generally contains fonts. And this point, this is actually necessary because otherwise you're not going to see the icons in the prompt, which is actually what makes the prompt actually look very nice. So to do that, what I'm going to do is I'm going to open my home directory. And this is the repository that I've just cloned. And I'm going to do is I'm going to just copy these fonts. I'm going to go back to the home directory. And then here I'm going to hit Control and H. So hold Control and press H, and all of the hidden files are going to be visible. And then just simply create a new folder called .fonts. And then simply paste those fonts here. And then you can go back to your home directory and again Control plus H, and you're going to get rid of the hidden directories. So now there's one more thing that we need to do before we go ahead and install that theme that I mentioned earlier. We need to install the GNOME tweak tool. So sudo apt install GNOME tweak tool. I think it's called GNOME Tweaks. Ah, yes. Yeah, so GNOME Tweaks. I think previously this used to be called GNOME Tweak Tools, but anyway, so it's GNOME Tweaks. Now that that is installed, I'm gonna go to my launcher and type tweaks. We're gonna see this icon here. Once this opens, we're gonna go to fonts. We'll look at this monospace font and we're going to change this to MESLO, Meslo LGS regular. Regular is fine. You can actually select one of those, but it has, the name has to be this. So if you want italic, it's up to you, but I generally just go with the Meslo LGS nerd font and a regular. So I'm going to select this. And now I'm just going to close this. Now you'll notice that this actually seems to be a little bit messed up, right? Well, there's no need to worry. You just have to close the terminal. And just open it again. And you're going to see that now it looks fine, right? So now we need to install that theme, and what the theme is called powerlevel10k. The first result is going to get us there, and then we need to install it in oh-my-zsh. I'm going to copy the link again, and I'm going to paste it and press enter. Okay, so what this means is that I have already cloned that. What I'm going to do is now there's one more step left to enable this theme, and that is we have to edit the zsh resource config file. And the way to do that is vim and .zshrc. Okay, I don't have vim, so I'm going to go ahead and use gedit. Alright, so this is the ZSS theme that we have. All we're going to do is going to write powerlevel10k / powerlevel10k. So this is all you have to do. Press Ctrl and S or click the save icon, close it. We're going to close this terminal one last time. We're going to open it again. Okay, so there needs to be one more key here. So I'm just going to edit this again. I need to add 1k here again. So now I'm going to close this again, let's reopen this, and there we have it. So now if we install the font correctly, we're supposed to see the things that it says. Like, does this look like a diamond? So I'm going to say yes. Does this look like a log? Yes. Does this look like a Debian logo? Yes. Yes. You can actually customize it the way you like. I just typically want to keep the rainbow. And then you're going to make sure you want to use Unicode at this point. And then I would go without any. No, I don't want to see current time. Angle is fine. Sharp head is good. Tails can be round. I prefer it in two lines. Disconnected, no frame, sparse, many icons, concise, yes, verbose, yes. And this is it. That's all there is. You can see this nice prompt here. I can actually go to any folder that contains a Git repository. So maybe like, let's go to this directory, and you're gonna see that it shows the branch, the name of the branch, and it also shows this icon here. So since this repository is being hosted on GitHub, it's going to show the GitHub icon, and if I had another repository that was hosted on GitLab, it's going to show GitLab's icon here. And when it's green, this means that working directory is actually clean. So I can say git status, and you can see working directory clean. When it is so this actually represents that the directory is clean. And if I do something like touch some file.txt, you're gonna see that now we have one untracked file, okay? And if I modify a tracked file, so maybe let's just edit the README, you're gonna see that now we have one untracked file and we have one tracked file, but with changes, right? And if a command takes a little while, it's always gonna show the amount of time that it has spent. And this actually also shows if you're behind your master branch or whatever branch you are on. So if the remote branch is ahead of you, it's going to show down arrows. If you are ahead of the remote branch, it's going to show. So for example, I can just go ahead and git commit just temp commit, maybe, I don't know. Let me just first add these and then commit it. Now you can see that I have two modifications. Okay, now wait. This means I've added two files, right? So test commit. This is, like I said, a really fresh installation of Ubuntu, so it's gonna take a little while. That's fine. You can just use the default values here. Right, so there you go. So now I've committed something. And you can see that it says that there's this up arrow in one. It means that I need to push something to the remote branch. And this is actually really helpful. So the process is pretty much the same on Mac as well, and even on this Windows subsystem for Linux. For Mac, you don't have to install the fonts if you use the correct terminal. But I'm going to make another video for Mac and Windows later on. So for now, I think I just hope this helps somebody. I actually spent a lot of time, trying to configure this. Sometimes I would get the font wrong. Sometimes I would do other, mess things up. But I thought I'd just make a video for somebody else, like anybody else who is trying to get this terminal. Okay, so like and subscribe. And I'm going to see you in the next video. Thanks.